When the doors of our Sunday school closed, God opened several connecting doors for our Sunday school to run smoothly. And we're so grateful for your willing hearts as students, as teachers, as volunteers, and even as parents. Looking back, we were able to conduct our Sunday school classes, our vacation Bible school, our holiday Bible school, and even observe our Sunday school day and conduct our assessments as well. Today, with thankful hearts, praising God, we celebrate our first ever virtual Sunday School anniversary program. To begin with, we invite our dearest and beloved Reverend Shaji Jacob Achin to open with the opening prayer.
Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we thank you for bringing us together at this virtual anniversary celebration of the Dubai CSI Parish Sunday School. Lord, as we have been going through a severe pandemic, even though we were unable to come together physically, you have helped us to continue all our Sunday school activities throughout this year. Merciful Lord, as we celebrate the anniversary today, we thank you for all the children who are participating in today's program. Thank you for the wonderful talents you have given to them. We pray that you help them to use those talents for the furtherance of your kingdom. We especially thank you for all the teachers and parents who worked hard to help the children to participate and perform today's programs. We praise you for all those who are attending this event from different parts of the globe. We humbly ask for your presence among all of us throughout this event. We ask all these things in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. We rejoice in this day with you. And we are so happy to be celebrating this day, a year of God's favor and provision, the year 2020. We can say this with confidence. If we are kept standing, it is by God's grace alone. A very warm welcome to all of you, especially our Achin and Kochama, our Sunday School Committee, our Church Committee, Shanta Aunty, our teachers, our parents, both from Fujairah and Dubai, our volunteers, our well-wishers, both local and global, and last but not the least, our dear, dear children. A big welcome, a warm and hearty welcome to you. Without much further ado, let's commence with our first program by our little stars, our KG classes. Here we go.
Lord, if we could, we would fill our hands with all the wonderful things you give us. Then we'd lift them up and give them back to you.
I give it to you, Lord. lovely to see our little ones on the screen. Thank you, dear ones. The students of grade 1 will now be presenting their program on the song, It's a Great Day to Praise the Lord.
For the gentle reminder that every day is a great day to praise the Lord. Don't we all love to listen to stories told by our parents or teachers or even our elder siblings? Next, let's eagerly watch what the storytellers of grade 3 want to tell us all.
Are delighted to share with you the stories and messages learned this year in Sunday school. So, let's get started.
Friends, Hebrews chapter 13 verse 2 says, "Do not forget to show hospitality to strangers." Rebecca was kind enough to draw water from the well for an absolute stranger, Eliza, and his camels too.
We were told to try hard
to lead a righteous life like Abraham and Noah. Psalm chapter 84 verses 11 says, "No good things receive return from those who walk his plainly.
Cast your cares on the Lord and he will sustain you." Psalms 55 verses 22. This is a verse that shows us God is with us in any situation in life. God has control even on circumstances which we have no control on. And that God gives peace and serenity in our hearts. In our Sunday school sessions, we learned how Jesus calms the storm. Today, we are going to present the story.
One day, Jesus said to his disciples, "Let us go over to the other side of the lake." So they got into a boat and set out. He was very tired as he was traveling the whole day preaching God's word and healing the sick. As they sailed, he fell asleep.
Suddenly, there was a big storm came down on the lake so that the boat was being rocked by the powerful waves and they were in great danger.
The disciples were scared. They started to cry out for help. They cried out, "Master, Master, we're going to drown." They woke up Jesus from his sleep.
He got up and rebuked the wind and the raging waters. The storm subsided and all was calm.
Jesus asked his disciples, "Where's your faith?" In fear and amazement, they asked one another, "Who is this?" He even commands the wind and the waters, and they obey him.
Jesus can help us in any circumstance. Jesus provides us protection, comfort during our sorrows, worries, illness, and fears. Therefore, let us trust in Jesus, obey him, and rely on him.
We learned our Lord is the strongest of all. Jericho was well known for its strong walls, but it just took some loud sounding trumpets to bring it down. Proverbs chapter 3 verses 5. Trust in the Lord with all your heart.
We learn the importance of a prayerful life. Hannah prayed for her son and Samuel was born. Do you know, friends, Danny prayed 3 times a day. Even the lions do not touch him.
Friends, this is a difficult one. We definitely need to be more obedient. Have you read the story in the Bible about Jonah? It is scary. Ephesians chapter 6 verses 1 says, "Children, obey your parents in the Lord."
Once upon a time, a farmer went to sow seeds. And as he was scattering, some fell along the path. The birds came and ate it.
But then some fell on rocky places where there was very little soil. And guess what? It grew quickly because the soil was shallow. But alas, the sun came and all the plants died because it had no root.
Well, well. Some fell along the path, some on rocky areas, but some on thorns. But when they grew up, they choked the other plants.
The seeds might have fallen in the wrong places. There were some seeds that fell on the good soil. And you know what? A crop was produced more than what was sown.
But hey, we know that Jesus speaks in parables. Likewise, what are those parables trying to teach us? The seed sown along the path is the man who hears the message of God, but then the evil snatches it.
The seed that falls on rocky places tells us about a man who hears it with joy but does not have root, so it doesn't last long.
The seed that fell among thorns is the man who hears the word, but the worries of his life makes it unfruitful.
Lastly, the seed that fell on good soil is the man who hears the word and understands it and reaps a crop even more than what is sown.
Our Savior healed the blind Bartimaeus, the lame man, and gave life to Lazarus. We want to praise Him with our talents to give Him our best.
Special choreography for us. Here it comes.
This heart.
you, dear students of grade 5. The next class coming up on our screens are the students of grade 7 who are going to present a skit titled The Love of Jesus.
Praise the Lord! Grade 7 is presenting a skit, Love of Jesus, taken from Bible John chapter, beginning from 13 to 21.
Jesus washes his disciples' feet.
Jesus poured water into a basin and began to wash his disciples' feet. Drying them with a towel that was wrapped around him, he came to Peter.
Lord, are you going to wash my feet?
You do not realize now what I am doing, but later you will understand.
No, you shall never wash my feet.
Unless I wash you, you have no part with me. Now that I, your Lord and teacher, have washed you, you should also wash one another's feet.
Jesus predicts his betrayal.
I tell you the truth. One of you is going to betray me.
Lord, who is it?
It is the one to whom I give this piece of bread when I have dipped it in the dish. I will be with you only a little longer. Where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new command. Love one another as I have loved you. So you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples if you love one another.
Lord, where are you going?
Where I am going, you cannot follow now, but you will follow later.
Lord, why can't I follow you now? I will lay down my life for you.
Will you really lay down your life for me? Very truly I tell you, before the rooster, you will disown me 3 times.
Jesus comforts his disciples.
Lord, we don't know where you are going, so how can we know the way?
I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you really know me, you know my Father as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him.
Lord, show us the Father, and that will be enough for us.
Don't you know me, Philip, even after being among with you for such a long time? Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Don't you believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me?
But Lord, why do you intend to show yourself to us and not to the world?
Anyone who loves me will obey my teachings. My Father will love them, and we will come to them and make our home with them.
Jesus arrested.
When he had finished praying, Jesus left with his disciples and crossed the Kidron Valley. On the other side, there was a garden, and he and his disciples went into it. So Judas came to the garden guiding a detachment of soldiers and some officials from the chief priests and the Pharisees.
Who is it you want?
Jesus of Nazareth.
I am he.
Peter drew the sword and struck the high priest's servant, cutting off his right ear.
Peter, put your sword away. Shall I not drink the cup the Father has given me?
Then the detachment of soldiers with its commander and the Jewish officials arrested Jesus. They bound him and brought him first to Annas, who was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, the high priest that year.
Peter's denial of Jesus. Peter and another disciple were following Jesus and reached into the high priest's courtyard. But Peter had to wait outside at the door. The other disciple, who was known to the high priest, came back, spoke to the servant girl on duty there, and brought Peter in.
You aren't one of this man's disciples too, are you?
I am not.
It was cold, and the servants and officials stood around a fire they had made to keep warm. Peter was also present, warming himself.
You aren't one of this man's disciples, are you?
I am not.
Didn't I see you with him in the garden?
Not me.
At that moment, a rooster began to crow.
Jesus before the Pilate.
Then the Jewish leaders took Jesus from Caiaphas to the palace of the Roman governor.
What charges are you bringing against this man?
If he were not a criminal, we would not have handed over to you.
Are you the king of the Jews?
My kingdom is not of this world. If it were, my servants would fight to prevent my arrest from the Jews. But now, my kingdom is from another place.
I find no basis for a charge against him. Do you want me to release the king of the Jews?
No, not him.
The Jews kept shouting. Pilate tried to convince them by flogging Jesus, but ultimately was forced to crucify Jesus. Jesus died and rose again in 3 days. Jesus appeared to his disciples. Now Mary stood outside the tomb, crying. As she wept, she looked into the tomb and saw two angels in white, seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot.
Woman, why are you crying?
They have taken my Lord away and I don't know where they have put him.
Mary!
Rabboni!
Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news and informed others. On the evening of that first day of the week, when the disciples were together with the doors locked for the fear of the Jewish leaders.
Peace be with you. Receive the Holy Spirit.
Now Thomas, 12, was not with the disciples when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord."
"Unless I see the nail marks in his hands and put my finger where the nails were and put my hand into his side, I will not believe."
"Peace be with you. Put your fingers here. See my hands. Reach out your hand and put it into my side. Stop doubting and believe."
"My Lord and my God."
"Because you have seen, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed."
Jesus reinstates Peter.
Peter and the other disciples were fishing time when Jesus appeared the third time to his disciples after he was raised from the dead. Jesus cooked some of the fish they had caught and ate with them after they had finished eating.
"Peter, son of John, do you love me more than these?"
"Yes, Lord, you know that I love you."
"Feed my lambs." "Peter, son of John, do you love me?"
"Yes, Lord, you know that I love you."
"Take care of my sheep." "Simon, son of John, do you love me?"
"Lord, you know all things. You know that I love you."
"Feed my sheep."
Jesus demonstrated his love for Peter by forgiving him and sins of all the mankind. Peter not only abandoned Jesus, but denied him 3 times. But still, Jesus wanted to make sure Peter understood his vital gospel mission he must do to follow him and glorify Jesus Christ's name. Jesus expects us to love one another. Thank you. May God bless you all.
Thank you, children of grade 7, for depicting an act of the love of Christ. Looking at all children beaming with joyful hearts, don't we often wonder, where do we find joy and how do we find it? Well, today, the kids of grade 2 would love to tell us and show us where do they find their joy. Fingers crossed, hoping you and I get to find and have the same joy as well.
Grade 2, thank you for that rendition. Thank you for reminding us, no matter the circumstances, in Christ we have joy. And now it's my pleasure to welcome our dear Rachin to share with us from the Word of God.
I bring you warm greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Respected office bearers and committee members of the church and the Sunday school, the Sunday school teachers, my dear children and parents, and all those who are listening to me on this virtual event. I'm sure at least some of you would have traveled or visited the Alps mountain in Europe, which is more than 3,500 meters above the sea level. It is spread over 8 different countries of Europe, and in fact more than 60% of the land of Switzerland and Austria are covered by the Alps mountain. You can go on top of it, of the mountain, by a cable car or a ropeway and stay at the peak. It is mostly covered with snow during the winter, but if you stay there for a few minutes without a sunglass, your eyes will start paining because it is so pure white all over, and the sun rays will be reflecting from the snow into your eyes. In the earlier days, a group of British botanists were visiting the Swiss Alps. They were collecting specimens and rare flowers. One morning, they walked from a small village and came to a very high cliff. From the cliff, they could see the green valley below, and they found a beautiful field of peculiar flowers, which was a breathtaking scene. The cliff was so deep that it was dangerous to go down the cliff. Then they found a small boy, a local boy, who was watching with interest all that they were doing. And one of the botanists told the boy, "If you could let us tie a rope around your waist and lower you over the cliff so that you can dig one of those plants for us, we will pay you an attractive cash gift." The boy was perplexed. After a few moments, he ran away, obviously frightened. After a few minutes, he came back. He came back with a man who was lean and gray. His hands were rough because of hard labor. And the boy told the group, "This is my father. I would go down on the rope if you could let my father hold on to this rope." The boy did not trust the team which had the latest equipment for climbing, but he trusted his father. What is the lesson we learn from this story? Our Sunday school children, whom do we trust? Of course, we should trust our parents and our siblings. But when it comes to the question of our family and friends, we have to be cautious and be selective. I don't want to go into the details of that. But whom shall we trust the most? It is the Lord our God. Proverbs 3:5 says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding." The most important thing that you learn in the Sunday school is to trust in God. In this process of your Sunday school life, you will be invited to accept Jesus Christ as your Savior. It may be at a VBS session or maybe at a church convention, children's meeting, or at some other occasion. But as we go through this Sunday school learning, you must learn to trust in God. Now let us see how the Sunday school was started. Sunday school is one of the most amazing inventions of the Christian era. In the Jewish community, children were encouraged to learn the word of God. Psalm 119 has a lot of insights regarding bringing up the young and the old according to the word of God. In the New Testament times, the emphasis was to bring men and women to the way of Jesus Christ so that their children will follow suit. The whole of Europe was basically Christian till the middle of the 15th century. And the children's training in the Christian education was mainly confined to their homes. At the beginning of the great spiritual awakening after the Reformation in Europe, children were given Bible lessons. But it was Robert Raikes and Thomas Stock who established Sunday School in 1780. Robert Raikes was the owner of a newspaper called Gloucester Journal, which he inherited from his father. And he was also interested in the prisons ministry. At the beginning of the Sunday school days, it was not just the Bible which was taught in the Sunday school. The children were taught reading, writing, and mathematics as well. For most of the poor children, this was the only education they got, as the children were employed as cheap laborers in factories, and they were to work 6 days a week. However, in the beginning, Sunday school did not get a wholehearted welcome. The church was opposed to teaching Sunday school on Sundays because teaching reading and writing and mathematics, the church thought was not right to do on a Sunday. During my own Sunday school days, I remember, we were not allowed to learn our school subjects on Saturday evenings because that was a time set apart for learning the Sunday school lessons and also for preparing for the Sunday service. Now, the industrialists in England, they thought that teaching the lower class people may not be a good idea because this may encourage them to leave the cheap labor job and search for better opportunities in life. The church also was not providing enough space for children to be taught. But the Sunday school quickly became very popular. They were good diversions for the children. Often the parents also joined the Sunday school. Thus, the Sunday school became a platform for social elevation of the family as a whole. Children were also encouraged to take their books home and share with their parents. But again, educating the whole family was not always possible because during the rapid industrialization process in England, parents and children were staying away from each other for work. However, in a limited way, Sunday school became a hub for interaction of lower class children and their parents who are moving from their own close-knit rural communities to the urban overpopulated areas. When the Sunday school movement got a momentum, the Church of England began supporting it by providing space and personnels, so it became more established. When we come to the history of Sunday school in India, when the missionaries came to India, they also mainly concentrated on the churches and the adult population. Locally, they helped the children to learn the word of God, but there was no systematic Sunday school as such during the olden days. In Madhya Kerala, the systematic Sunday school was started at Mallapalli by Archdeacon Umman Maman in the year 1880, some 140 years ago. Since then, the Sunday school movement gained strength, and today it is one of the most effective services the church renders to its believing community. I am immensely proud of the Dubai Sunday School. You have an efficient leadership and extremely hardworking teachers. And I am sure all of you children worked hard to make this event a great success. And there are a few others who work behind the curtain. I met one of them yesterday. A few days ago, he is Abin Varghese, the creator of this virtual presentation, whose parents told me that he has neither been sleeping for a few nights nor going for work. I salute all those who have dedicated their precious time for making this event a great success. I congratulate all the children from all grades who have contributed to this event through various programs. May God bless you. May God use your talents for His glory. Amen.
Thank you, dear Rachin, for your inspiring words. Daniel is a very well-known character to us from the Bible. The students of grade 4 would like to tell you a story titled Daniel in the Lion's Den.
Don't ever be afraid or discouraged. I am the Lord your God. I will be there to help you wherever you go. Joshua 1:9. This is the words that strengthens each and every one of us, especially at this tough time. In our Sunday school session, we learned about a man who stood strong. Man of God who stood strong and believes in God, and God rescued from the jaws of death. Yes, the same Lord lives in your life too. We, the class 4, are going to tell about a small story about nobleman Daniel in the lion's den and how wonderful did God protect them.
King Darius, king of mighty Medes and Persians, needs someone to be chief ruler in Babylon. He chose Daniel, whom he knew to be brave, wise and honest. The other rulers were angry. They couldn't believe that a foreigner had been chosen over them. They worked out a trap to catch Daniel. What are we going to do? We can't get Daniel such an important job. We will get rid of him. Let's go to King Darius and get him to make a law that will make Daniel do something wrong. What sort of law should we suggest? I know, something to do with Daniel's religion and his God. Yes, that's a great idea. Let's go to the Medes and Persians worship many gods, but Daniel worshipped only the God of Israel, the one true God. The jealous rulers knew that Daniel prayed often to his God. So with fast beating hearts, the ruler went to the king, and the king lived forever.
All the rulers have agreed. You should make a law saying that for 30 days, no one should pray to any god or man except you. And if anyone disobeys the law, they should be thrown to the lions. And the king Darius replied, "Oh, what a nice thing to suggest. My rulers must think I'm a great king if they want this law. Of course, I'm a pretty good king. Yes, I like that idea, and this law should be written down immediately." King Darius replied, "Very well, I will write it down." Happily, the rulers watched King Darius write down the law. They knew that once a law of the Medes and Persians was written down, it could never be changed.
The law was told to everyone in the land. As soon as Daniel heard it, he knew it was a trap set for him. He must either give up his daily prayers to God or be thrown into the lions. What am I going to do? I can save my life by not praying to God for 30 days. I can save my life by praying secretly in my head. I know I could find a hiding place and pray. No, I know what I must do. Daniel went into his house. Upstairs he went into the front room where he always prayed. He opened the window which faced Jerusalem, his own country, far away.
Daniel prayed to God to help him with his problem. Daniel did not try and hide his prayer, but prayed just like he had before the new law. "Look, Daniel in the window. He appears to be praying just like usual. Yes, our plan worked. Quick, let's go tell the king." They rushed off to tell King Darius. "King Darius, live forever. Did you not make a law saying that anyone who prays to any god or man except you, these 30 days should be thrown to the lions?" King Darius replied, "Yes, I did. You were the ones who suggested I make such a law. Well, Daniel, who's one of the Jews captured and brought to Babylon years ago, takes no notice of your law. He's still praying to his God 3 times a day. How did this happen? I must find a way to change the law. Daniel is one of my favorite leaders. I must put an end to this law.
All day, King Darius tried a way to help Daniel, but it was no use. King Darius himself had written the law down and it could not be changed. King, it is now evening and you must decide what to do about Daniel. You must carry out the law as you wrote it. Yes, Daniel must be punished to show others he has broken your law. He must be taken to the lion's den. I have no choice. Daniel is to be brought to the lion's den. So Daniel was brought to the edge of the lion's den. The hungry lions paced backwards and forwards roaring. Bravely Daniel waited, then the men threw him in.
Daniel, may the God to whom your so faithful Savior, then hardly able to watch, Darius watched as a huge stone was rolled into place over the entrance to the den. Then King Darius had to seal the stone with his own ring so that everyone would know if the stone had been moved in a rescue attempt. Then King Darius went back to his palace. I cannot sleep or eat. I'm so worried about Daniel. What have I done? At the first sign of morning, he hurried back to the lion's den, but he just stopped before he got there. What would he see? His friend torn into pieces. Fearfully, he called out.
Daniel, has your God saved you? O King, live forever. I am safe. God did not let the lions harm me. I ordered you to get Daniel out. What? He is not dead? How can this be? The men who had thrown Daniel into the den now lifted him out. Sure enough, he was completely untouched by the lions. After a joyful greeting, King Darius issued another order. You rose there. You have accused Daniel and now I accused you. You shall be thrown into the lion's den. No, and so the rulers who had tried to trick Daniel and the king were themselves thrown into the lion's den. Even before they touched the floor of the den, the lions sprang on them and it tore them to pieces.
Tell all the people, in my kingdom I have a new law. I command that everyone should respect Daniel's God. For this God is truly great and will last forever. We have learned the below 4 things and we would practice it in our daily lives. God is with us in good and bad times. God listens to us when we pray. Like Daniel, God wants us to pray regularly. Like Daniel, we should trust God even when it is hard. Yes, we are the witnesses of God and we would live like Daniel.
Thank you, children of grade 4, for sweetly enacting the story of Daniel. Let's next check out what the 10th graders wants to share with us today.
Our homes is the safest place for us to fight against this pandemic situation more than any other protective things. Staying at home with our loved ones is the most safest thing.
Any
Anytime we stay away from God, we make ourselves vulnerable to Satan's temptations and spiritual deceptions, leading us to make unwise choices that can cause serious consequences. The only true place to be is in the center of God's will in our life. As long as we follow where He leads, we'll be protected, even in situations that might appear dangerous or threatening to human eyes. Psalmist says in Psalms 23 verse 4 that we have to walk through some dark valleys, but even in the shadow of death, we have the security of knowing that we're never walking alone. The light of the world is always with us. When we stay in a home where there's Christ, there's perfect peace. Perfect peace is not the absence of fear, but the presence of God.
Regular hand wash cleanses or sanitization. This is the best method to break the chain for the spreading of the virus attack.
We know the deadly nature of human sin, how it spread from the first man to contaminate the entire human race. 1 John chapter 1 verse 7 says that blood of Jesus Christ cleanses us from all sin. Believe in Christ that cleanses us from all sin, and we will be a child of God, where your life is fully protected, here on earth and in the life to come. 1 John chapter 5 verse 18 says that we know that God's children live under the practice of sin, for God's Son holds them securely, and the evil one cannot touch them. Satan cannot harm us if we are a true child of God.
Use the face mask. If you have to go out, kindly use appropriate face mask. This will protect you from the virus attack when you are exposed to such situations.
Control your tongue. Proverbs 15:28 says, "The heart of the godly thinks carefully before speaking. The mouth of the wicked overflows with evil words." Remember this proverb. A word spoken can never be taken back. God wants us to control what we speak. Paul says in Colossians 4:6, "Let your speech always be gracious, seasoned with salt, so that you may know how you ought to answer each other."
Keep a social distance as per WHO regulations, a minimum of 2-meter distance to be kept when you're meeting with people. This is to avoid the chance of spreading the virus by contact.
Keep away from evil ways. 1 Thessalonians 5 verses 22 says, "Stay away from every kind of evil." We need to stay away from evil so that we are not tempted to do things that will displease our Lord. Yes, we often fall and have to ask for forgiveness, but what has changed is our desires. No longer do we look for evil, even going out of our way to find it. Instead, through the help of the Holy Spirit within us, we stay away. Psalmist says in Psalm 1 verses 1 that, "Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, or set foot on the path of sinners, or sit in the seat of mockers." Lord teaches us to keep distance from sinful nature in order to be blessed.
Increase your immunity. Take the proper food vitamins, which will help you to increase your immune system, so that it will protect you from the virus attack.
spiritual immunity. Increase our spiritual immunity by meditating the Word of God. As you study the Word, the leading of the Holy Spirit in your life will increase, for you will be able to recognize His voice. 2 Timothy 3:16-17 says, "All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be perfect, thoroughly furnished unto all good works." The more you let the Word of God dominate your mind, your decisions, and your outlook on life, the more the Holy Spirit controls your life and leads you from victory to victory. And that can be obtained only by praying and reading the scripture daily in living to obedience to God.
Taking the appropriate vaccine when it is available. Vaccination is a simple, safe, and effective way to protect us from harmful diseases. Wait until the vaccine for COVID-19 is available to stay safe from the virus attack, which is a threat to our lives.
Salvation vaccine ready since 2000 years. Accepting Christ as our personal Savior is the only way, or the vaccine that saves us from death and gives us eternal life. It's not costly, it's not time consuming. The Bible says in John 3:16, "For God so loved the world, He gave His only begotten Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." We just need to believe and accept Christ as our Savior. The choice is yours. Believe in Christ and be saved.
Wow, grade 10, well done, well done. A fine perspective of the new normal indeed. And now let's welcome grade 6, who are ready with their joyful song and dance. Here it comes.
Mera raja hai mahaan.
Thank you, dear students of grade 6, for a very energizing presentation that had all of us singing and worshipping and praising the Lord together. The next class to be presenting are the students of grade 8, who are going to present a short movie titled The Helpline, followed by a choreography titled He Answers. Presenting to you, grade 8.
How many hours I've been working on this? I really hope I can prepare it. Kitten Nalila, what do I do? Steve! You never put it back on. Steve! Steve, நீ இங்கோட்டு வந்து வாங்க. ஓ நோ ஸ்டீவ் கேம் கழிக்கிறாரு கேம் கழிச்சு கூடுனுண்ட. ஸ்டீவ் நீ இங்கோட்டு வந்து வாங்க. ஐ நீட் ஹெல்ப் ஆன் மை லேப்டாப். ஐ கான்ட் சீம் டு ரிட்ரீவ் தி ஃபைல் ஐ வாஸ் வர்க்கிங் ஆன். ஸ்டீவ்
ஆல்வேஸ் வென் ஐ அம் ப்ளேயிங் ஒன்லி. வை இஸ் ஹி நாட் ஆஸ்கிங் டேவ்? வெயிட். Dad, I'm just finishing something very important. I'll call Dave, get up. Papa's calling you.
What do you want?
Papa needs your help with something. Get up.
I'm going to hold you in the morning. What is it now? Can't Dad just wait?
Dave, that's not the way to talk. You can always sleep later. Go and help Papa.
Dave, please help me here. I have a document that I need to submit quickly. I just don't know where it went. I need your help to retrieve it. Can you just see if you can do something?
I'm also trying, but nothing is happening. I told you earlier, so we need to express this issue to an expert. Only they'll be able to help you.
I need to submit this quickly. An expert, where do I find one right now?
Let me call Sophie. I've heard her son George is into a lot of projects. Maybe he can help. Hi Sophie.
Susan, hi. How are you? Long time, Alec.
Yes, long time. I desperately needed help. Is Josh around there? My husband needed to urgently check something with Josh.
Sure, 1 minute. Josh?
Hi uncle, how are you? Going good uncle. Is there anything I can help you with? Sorry, Uncle. I couldn't help. It's okay, Josh. Not to worry.
Thank you so much for taking the time.
Uncle, wait. Let me speak to a few of my friends. Okay, Uncle. Take care. We'll call you back. Who should I call? Let me try and WhatsApp Jay. Maybe he can help.
This is all I can do to help. Okay, yeah. Take it. Bye. God bless you.
Who can I call now? Thomas' uncle's home? Maybe Matt. Vilichu nokka. Uncle, Josh here.
Hi Josh, how are you? How studies?
Going good, Uncle. Uncle, I needed some help. Do you know how to retrieve a lost file from a PC?
No, Monet, but I'm sure Max will be the help. Wait, let me give it to him. Matt, Josh is on the line.
Appa, enna vilichu. Hey Josh, what's up man? Long time.
Edda, I need some help. Steve's dad needed some help in recovering a document. I tried several things but still didn't work.
Did you try restarting the laptop? What about? Sorry, Da. There's nothing more that I can help you with.
No worries. It's okay, Josh. Not to worry. Thank you so much for taking the time. May God bless you. Now, what do I do?
Dad, is it not done yet?
You have no idea of how much people we have tried to reach. They all were not able to help us.
Dad, as I've been trying to tell you, call the expert. Support us through Vilchinokio. That's the only place you needed to call.
Sheria. The support desk. The helpline. That's where I should have contacted.
So dear friends, many a times aren't we also like Steve's dad? We run into a problem and think about it to possibly all we know and forget where we actually need to bring it to. We tire ourselves looking for solutions and tend to make a bigger mess than there already was. We complicate simple things. In this journey of life, we may encounter problems on a daily basis, some of which may seem impossible. Jesus says, "Come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest." In spite of knowing this, we run everywhere looking for a solution to our problems, except to the Lord. This new year, may we resolve in our hearts to come to the Lord first in prayer. Who better would know us than the one who made us and knows what we fully need? He is the one solution. Jesus is the answer. I am now reminded of how the psalmists say in Psalms 121 verse 2 that our help comes from the Lord. I would now like to hand it over to my classmates from grade 8 who bring you a small choreography on the song, The Answer.
questions. The world is reaching. So many hurting, so many lost. With all this striving, who can we lean on? Creation's crying out from the dark.
Kids' talents and efforts amidst being hard pressed for time. Next, let's together watch what our Achachas and Chachis of 11th grade wants to present today.
He is the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. These lines speak about none other than Jesus, who gave everything to his friends, his knowledge of God the Father, and his own life. Jesus is our role model for friendship because he loved without limits, and he makes it possible for us to live a life of friendship because we have been transformed by everything he shared with us. In the 19th century in England, there lived a Salvationist named Charles William Fry, and he wrote a beautiful hymn for those in trouble and in despair, for those who need someone to lean on, Lily of the Valley. We, the class of 11th grade, would like to sing this song as an offering to our entire Sunday school, our parents and our teachers, and our beloved friends.
I have found a friend in Jesus. He's everything to me. He's the fairest of 10,000 to my soul. forget and make me fully whole. Even sorrow is my comfort, and trouble is my stay. It infects me every day or into long. It's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. It's the fairest of the thousand in my soul. He on my grief has taken, and all my sorrows more. In temptation he's my strong and mighty tower. How I mourn for him forsaken, out of my heart and soul. From my heart and now he leads me by his side. No more, no one forsake me, and Satan tempt me so. Through Jesus I shall safely reach the Lord. He's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. He's the fairest of the thousand in my soul. He will never, never leave me, nor yet forsake me. While I live by faith and do his blessed will. I walk far above me, I've nothing now to fear. With his more love, he will not rest or shall fail. When crowned and lost in glory, I'll see his blessed face. Something I shall ever know. He's the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star. He's the fairest of the thousand to my soul.
James 1 verse 5. If any one of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you.
Romans chapter 12 verse 2. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, yet be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing and perfect will.
Philippians chapter 4 verses 6 and 7 says, do not be anxious about anything, but in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus.
James 1 verse 26. Those who consider themselves religious and yet do not keep a tight rein on their tongues deceive themselves, and their religion is worthless.
Thank you, grade 11. So true. There is no friend like Jesus. Praise God. And now we move on to the next program by our grade 9. Here we go.
Greetings to one and all in the powerful name of our Lord. We, the students of grade 9, would like to share some of our thoughts from the lessons that we have learned this year.
Our lessons cover topics such as overcoming temptations, the fruits of obedience, the Holy Spirit and confirmation, God's love and human's love, and forgiveness.
We have also traveled through the epistles and discussed the relevance of the Ten Commandments in our lives.
An important takeaway for us has been that sin always starts with an action from our side. Perhaps a small moment of temptation or a moment of uncontrolled thought, word, or action.
And if not for God's unconditional love for us that covers all our weaknesses, we would have fallen a long time ago and we would have been doomed to eternal guilt and condemnation.
Just as the branches need to stay connected to the vine in order to survive and grow, we understand that we need to continually stay connected to bear the right fruit.
Overcoming temptations isn't easy for us and we can't do it by ourselves. But if we trust in God and work on holding on to Him, whatever the circumstances, then we can overcome our temptations.
Today, we would like to present a skit titled Chains of Lying. Here is a young boy, Billy, just going about his day.
One morning, just before school, Billy's mom asked him,
Billy!
Yes, mom?
Here's 10 dirhams. On the way back from school, can you please give the shopkeeper downstairs this money?
Okay, mom.
Have a good day.
Bye, mom.
Billy went to school and on his way back, discovered 10 dirhams in his pocket. So he went to the sweet shop and spent it all on sweets, completely forgetting the money belonged to his mother and was meant to be given to the shopkeeper.
When Billy arrived home, his mother asked him,
was the shopkeeper busy when you went down to the shop?
No, mom, not busy.
Lie number one.
Billy, could I have the change? There should be 4 dirhams.
I hope you don't mind, but I gave my money to Dion. He needed for a bus fare and he lost his money. He said he would give it to me tomorrow.
That was the second lie Billy told.
Oh, okay. But make sure you bring back home the money tomorrow.
The next day, Billy remembered that he had to borrow 4 dirhams to return to his mother that night. He asked all his friends if they could lend him 4 dirhams, but none of them had any money.
Bro, Dion, can you check if you have 4 dirhams?
No, bro. I've spent all my money on lunch.
Can you check again, please? I really need it. I'll return it to you tomorrow, I promise.
Babe? Nothing. Nothing at all.
So in desperation, he went to his teacher and said,
Mom, may I come? Mom, I need some money to meet my grandmother in the hospital. She's very sick and I need to go there and I don't have the money for the bus fare. So could I please borrow some money?
Lie number 3.
I hope your grandma soon feels better.
Thank you, Mom.
That evening, Billy knew he had to repay his teacher the next day. So he decided to invent a school trip he had to go on with his class. So as to not make his mother suspicious, he decided to ask her for 5 dirhams.
Mom, I need 5 dirhams for a school trip tomorrow.
Lie number 4.
Where are you going?
To some park.
Lie number 5.
Why hasn't the school sent the circular?
Well, they did, but I lost it.
Lie number 6.
Oh, Billy, you can be so careless. Okay, I'll give you 5 dirhams. By the way, the shopkeeper said he didn't meet you yesterday. What happened?
They were really busy, so there were many people in the shop and I gave it to another man. He said he will give it to him.
Lie number 7.
Oh, okay. Well, as long as you gave the money.
Of course I did, Mom. You know what? The other man was wearing a red shirt and I remember that too.
Lie number 8.
Billy went to school the next day with 5 dirhams to pay back his teacher.
Mom, here you go. Thank you.
Thank you, Billy. I do hope your grandma is feeling a bit better. I'm sure that she was pleased to meet you. Oh, and I'm so looking forward to seeing your parents at the parent-teacher meeting tonight. Also, I want you to have this letter. I have decided to take you and the rest of your class on a class trip, as we haven't had one for such a long time. We're going to a museum.
That evening, when Billy went home, he couldn't face his mother. He was in big trouble and caught up in his own web of sin. It started out really small, but now he was drowning in it. He could have chosen to keep quiet and eventually it would have been forgotten. But in his heart, he knew that wasn't the right way. There was only one way to make this right. He kneeled down in prayer and asked the Lord for forgiveness. He asked the Lord to control his tongue and help him remember instructions better. He asked the Lord to make him a better son and a better person. And then, fully aware of the consequences, he went and told his mother the truth.
Jesus is the only one who can bring us freedom. He brings us freedom from sin and freedom from guilt, so that we are free to know our Heavenly Father and live the life that He has created for us to live.
Let us not be trapped even by the smallest tricks that prevent us from being full images of Christ. Instead, let us work on being fully committed children of God.
Thank you, dear students of grade 9, for a very thought-provoking skit. Our final presentation for today is by the students of grade 12, who are also our senior-most students and the graduating class of this year. The students of grade 12 represent a song and a skit titled Letter from Hell.
What if you had a friend who died without knowing Jesus as their personal savior? What if he or she went to hell? What if one day you received a letter in the mail from beyond this life? A letter from your friend who is now in the flames of eternal torment. Although Jess had every opportunity to tell Josh about Jesus, she didn't. They were best friends. They played together. They went to classes together. They shared the good times on earth with each other. But there was one thing Jess did not share with Josh: her personal relationship with Jesus Christ. The rest of the story is simple and sad. One day, Josh had a few too many dreams: a tragic drive home, a crash, a death, and a funeral. Then Jess gets a letter from Josh. A letter from hell.
Dear Jess, I died today. It's a lot different than I expected. You see, I always thought dying would bring me into a world. Well, not really there. But this place, it's real. It's as real as my life on earth. I can think, I can talk, I can even feel. Right after the wreck, I could feel my spirit leaving my body. It was the weirdest thing. I could hear people around screaming out to me. At first, I was just standing in a line at a gate. They asked me for my name and they began to look for it in this book called the Book of Life. Since they couldn't find me in it, an agent of the devil grabbed me by the arm and started dragging me away. I was terrified. I had no idea what was going on. I asked him where he was taking me, but he didn't answer. So I kept on asking him. Finally, he told me those whose names were written in the Book of Life would live for eternity in heaven, and that the rest would be condemned to hell forever. He threw me in some kind of holding cell where I've been sitting and thinking for a long, long time. Do you know what I've been thinking about? I've been thinking about you, Jess. You are a Christian. You have told me so yourself. I mean, we talked about it a few different times. Kelly brought it up and you laughed it off. Coach Adams brought it up and you changed the subject. They were even talking about it right before the crash today. The question I can't get out of my mind is this, Jess. Why haven't you ever told me about how to become a Christian? You say you're my friend, but if you really were, you would have told me more about Jesus. You would have told me how to escape this terrible place that I'm headed for now. I can feel my heart pounding in my chest. The devil's agents who are about to throw me into hell are coming down the hallway. I can hear their footsteps. I've heard of this, Jess. They call it the Lake of Fire. I can't stand it, Jess. I'm terrified. They're coming for me. Why, Jess? Why didn't you ever tell me about Jesus?
Matthew 28, verse 19 to 20 says, "Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely, I am with you always to the very end of the age." Our mission on earth as fellow Christians is to spread the good news of salvation through Jesus Christ. There is still a large number of people that remain unaware of the promises of eternal life through Jesus Christ. It is our duty to be His disciples and to fulfill the Great Commission. As this year's graduating class, we commit our lives to be His disciples, and also would like to leave you all with a reminder to help carry out the Great Commission so that we may touch the hearts of those around us to choose eternity with our Lord Jesus Christ.
I can see it in your eyes that you are restless. The time has come for you to leave. It's so hard to let you go, but in this life I know you have to be who you were made to be. As you step out on the road, I'll say a prayer, so that in my heart, you always will be there. This is not goodbye. I know we'll meet again. So let your life begin, 'cause
sex is not goodbye. It's just I love you to take with you until you're home again. Stirring in your soul has left you wondering, should you stay or turn around? Well, just remember that your dreams, they are a promise that you were made to change the world. So don't let fear stop you now, 'cause this is not goodbye. I know we'll meet again, so let your life begin, 'cause this is not goodbye. It's just I love you to take with you until you're home again. Oh, I know the bright star above was created by the one who loved more than we'll ever know.
That was not my turn. Oh, my goodness, I can hear it. Is raging now, and your only choice is to follow who you are. So follow who you are, 'cause this is not goodbye.
I know we'll meet again.
Children, together as your Sunday school family, we continue to place each and every one of you in our prayers, hoping that you trust in the Lord wherever He leads you. While we thank the Lord for the past year, it's time for us to now look at the Sunday School Annual Report, which would be presented by our Secretary, Mrs. Sonny Werke.
Greetings to all in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. With a heart full of gratitude, we submit the Sunday School Annual Report for the academic year 2020. Unlike any other year in the past, this year posed many challenges for the worshipping community in the form of the COVID-19 pandemic. But we have a faithful God, and we believe God makes a way where there seems to be no way. This year is special for us also, because we were blessed with the guidance and support of two parish vicars, Reverend Dr. P.K. Kurvula and Reverend Shaji Jacob Thomas. Shaji Achin took over as the parish vicar July 2020. And of course, we also had our dear Shanti Aunty to give us timely advice and guidance. The journey this last year. Reflecting back on 2020, we started the academic year on 17th January. Classes were conducted on Friday mornings from 9:10 a.m. followed by the common worship at 10 a.m. In March 2020, our Sunday school sessions were suspended temporarily between 6th March and 10th April due to the pandemic spread and the UAE government issuing orders to stop all public gatherings. By the grace of God Almighty and under the able leadership of Kurvula Achin and the technical guidance and support of Mr. Joy Vijay Kumar, we were able to recommence our Sunday school sessions via the Zoom virtual platform on 17 April. The online sessions are conducted every Friday morning from 8:30 a.m. to 9:45 a.m. The Fujairah Sunday School also joined us in the online session supported by Mr. Jose Maliel. This year, the Sunday School had a strength of 189 students, 30 teachers, 13 singing team members, and 3 tech support members. During the academic year, we organized 3 staff meetings. The first meeting was held on 10th January at the start of the academic year. Reverend Dr. P.K. Kurvula led the meeting and also delivered the message. The second meeting was held on 16th April. This was an orientation and training session for the Zoom sessions. Mr. Wesley P. Kurvula spoke from the Word of God during the meeting. His message was based on James 1 verses 5 to 8, ask God for guidance. The third meeting was held on 28th August. Our new vicar, Reverend Shaji Jacob Thomas, delivered the message based on the portion from Luke 2 verses 40 to 52. He spoke about helping children understand God's special purpose for them and guiding them to apply good virtues in their lives. We praise God Almighty for all the opportunities we had to learn from His Word and meditate on it. Even though the pandemic crippled the world in many ways, our God is mightier than any pandemic. He is our awesome God raining on us from heaven. By the grace of our God Almighty, we were able to carry out some of our programs this last year. In July and August 2020, we had the Holiday Bible School. Our theme this year was based on Colossians 1:10 and was titled Jewels of Value. The sessions were organized by Anjana John and Mary George over 6 weeks between 17 July and 21st August. We had a great time of learning and fun with the singing team and the 15 resource persons from our own parish. On October 16, 2020, we were able to conduct the memory verse competition. Praise be to God, 138 students from Dubai and Fujairah Sunday Schools participated in this event. The highest number of verses was attempted by Johan Alex, who recited an astounding 290 verses, and in the senior section, Shera Shibu scored at 118 verses. Same as every year, we praise God that this year also we were able to observe the Sunday School week on November 13, 2020. Our grade 12 students and senior teachers participated during the church service, and Miss Shreya Elizabeth Itti of grade 12 delivered the message on the day. We express our sincere thanks to all the students and teachers. Also, by the grace of God Almighty, we conducted the grade 12 graduation service on 8th January 2021. This year's class had 12 students graduating. We were blessed to hear from the word presented by Reverend George Jacob, who is the Madhya Kerala Diocese Sunday School General Secretary. This year, we bid farewell to some of our members who relocated back to Kerala. We said goodbye to Kurvula Achan, Kochma, Winnie and Wesley on 26th June 2020. We thank Achan and family for all their services, guidance and pastoral care and love during the past 3 years. We pray God Almighty will continue to use Achan and family for the service in His kingdom. We also bid goodbye to Jishan and children and Soumya and children in September. We will dearly miss them in our midst, praying for God's blessings on them now and always. And this year, we have been blessed to be pastored by Reverend Shaji Jacob Thomas. We welcome Achan and family to our Sunday School family and praise and thank God for the opportunity to learn and serve God alongside Achan. That was the Sunday School year in a flash. No organization functions without the support and effort of its people. Our Sunday School is immensely blessed with great talents and supporters. Here are the teams whose dedication and work through the year helps the Sunday School to function smoothly. We praise God Almighty for each and every one of them. First is our superb technical team. They have been our backbone this last year. Without their expert guidance and unrelenting dedication, Sunday School would have been impossible this year. Then our wonderfully talented and capable team of teachers. We start with the beginners team. Shilpa Anu joined the beginners this year. Then our primary teachers team. Sachin, Freda, Edna and Shiny stepped in to help us when we started the online sessions. The next is our junior team. Then our intermediate team, Anjana, took over from Soumya in September. And here is our senior team of teachers. A big thank you to all of them. Our singing team are the superstars. With their careful planning and detailed preparations every week, they conducted the common worship sessions beautifully, engrossing everyone. Jose Maliel and Joanna Maliel from Fujairah Church is also part of the singing team. Thank you, dear team, and God bless all your efforts. You have touched all of our hearts. The next is our Sunday School committee, the team that quietly works in the background, sometimes bullying the others. But overall, we are a bunch of lovely people. Our thanks to Achin and the Sunday School committee for their guidance and support to the Sunday School. We also extend our gratitude to the Holiday Bible School team, where a big team of 26 members came together to make it a memorable and fun event for the children. We also thank all the parents, the church committee, all those who supported us in prayer and other ways, and all the volunteers for standing with us throughout the year. And finally, here is the team that helped us put together the virtual anniversary program at such short notice. A special thanks to Evan Varghese for all the efforts, time and support he gave us. We thank God Almighty for His grace that helped us achieve all of this even in a year that seemed impossible at the beginning. We can only bow down before His awesomeness and might and remind ourselves, as it says in 1 Corinthians 1:9, God is faithful, by whom you were called into the fellowship of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Truly, He has led us by His right hand and blessed us. Thank you.
I would now like to invite the headmistress of our Sunday school, Mrs. Shanta Simon, who we lovingly call Shantanti, to lead in closing prayer, followed by benediction by our dear Achin.
Shall we all bow our heads in prayer? Our gracious and loving Heavenly Father, we wish to praise You and offer our humble gratitude to You for the spectacular and wonderful performances displayed by our Sunday school students. Although it was a traumatic year due to the pandemic, we confess that it was truly Your love, guidance, and inspiration working through everyone that has caused the smooth functioning of our beloved Sunday school. Right from the year 1979, it was definitely Your grace, mercy, and protection as well that have been the backbone of our existence. Our only dream is that all our students will prove themselves to be worthy of Your name and be regular churchgoers as well. Do strengthen our teachers and parents as well, dear Lord, because they are indeed our source of strength and support. We submit ourselves entirely into Your loving hands, dear Lord, knowing full well that with You in our hearts, we have nothing to fear. In Thy matchless name we pray. Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, young and old, to everyone who have joined us here online today, we have come to the end of the Sunday School anniversary of the CSI Parish Malayalam, Dubai. We pray that the different programs presented by our children may have inspired you and touched you, and that these may help you onward in your journey with the Lord. To God alone be the glory for all the wonderful talents presented by our children and for all the ideas and people who worked behind this. From everyone here, we wish you all a blessed 2021. Stay safe and God bless. Goodbye.